Assalamualaikum. I'm Hina Ejaz. Welcome to Pakistan. Somebody I will be welcoming in my show today is from Poland. I've had Polish guests before in the show, but they have been travelers and tourists. My guest today came to Pakistan exactly 4 years ago. She fell in love with Pakistan and decided to stay here. She is just not living here as a tourist who extended her stay. In fact, is a music professional. She manages musicians in Pakistan. She also used to organize music festivals in Poland, which sounds very exciting. I'd like to find out more about these music festivals, given Poland is a country whose history and culture are really, really rich. Now, how? It has a 1,000-year-old history. And there's so much to see and observe once one visits Poland. Now, with its 1,000-year history, the culture that the Polish people take forward in today's world, again, like I said, my guest is going to enrich us with that. We have Ms. Agata here. Agata is from Poland for the past 4 years in Pakistan, managing musicians. Hi, Agata. Assalamualaikum.
Walaikum assalam. Kya haal hai?
Greet in the Pakistani way.
Yes.
Right. How are you?
I'm fine. Bilkul theek hai. Ab batai.
4 years, how have they been for you?
It's been great. That's why I'm still here. Yes. I love it. I love
it. We'd like to know more about your great journey in Pakistan. But before that, I'd like you to meet my other guest, who is obviously from Pakistan, Dr. Ejaz. Doc Saab is, let's put it this way, because there's so much, there's a large introduction for Dr. Ejaz. So I don't know where to start from. But yes, he loves to travel. He's a member of a few travel, let's say, associations and forums. One forum is Pakistan Travelers Forum. He's a member of that. And then he's also a member of the Asian Civilization Society. He has a deep interest, a keen interest, and has always had it in traveling. He's going to tell us about his travel stories today, and is also, I'm sure, will be able to guide you, the ones who are looking to travel in Pakistan, in new and exciting places of Pakistan. And I'm sure, Agata, there's some stuff that we can learn from Dr. Saab today. Given again, his interaction skills, I'm sure, are great, because he heads a public sector college, and daily he connects and interacts with 4,000 students. I'm sure he talks a lot and hears a lot. He has a good listening power too. So, Doc Saab, Assalamu Alaikum and welcome to the show.
Welcome, Ji. Walaikum Salaam. Thank you very much for inviting me in this program. That's really very interesting.
I'm glad that you made it, Doc Saab.
Yeah,
given you meet 4,000 students every day, I'm sure this seems like a small group to you.
Yeah.
Well, yes, thank you for joining us. So, Agata, 4 years organizing music festivals in Poland. How did it happen? How did you find Pakistan on the world map?
Well, basically Pakistan found Poland on the map. They came for our festival and they invited us back. And I took the invitation because Pakistan is very exotic country and we don't know much about Pakistan. But when they came to Poland, I literally,
some Pakistanis came to
Poland. Pakistani team who was dancing at Katak and playing Pakistani music, they came to Poland. And I fell in love with the music, the culture, food, because they were also cooking for us.
Over there in Poland.
That was a part of our festival, that we wanted to know the culture. So not only music, but also food and every language. So I fell in love with what they brought and I wanted to know more, and I came here to
Pakistan. You came upon the invitation. They asked you to come here and also discover the music industry, is that right?
Yes. Because they were musicians, I basically became a part of musical circle, let's say, in Pakistan.
You know, it's a very intense job to manage musicians.
Yes, but I love
it. You have a different ethnicity, culture.
True.
Background,
true.
You know, you come from a different country altogether.
Yes.
Now, having the right connections for a music manager is very, very important, as you understand.
Yes.
So, managing musicians from another country Though you've been here for 4 years, fine, that's yes. long, but isn't it difficult? Isn't it challenging?
Well, I spent first three years in different music studios. I got to know all the main singers of Pakistan. They are my friends. So we ate awesome. Together.
American
we traveled. Yes, we traveled together.
Then
I thought, like, why not? Because this is not my main thing. Mainly, I am a teacher.
Where do you teach? Now I don't teach
English literature.
Lovely.
So in Poland I was doing that, and so that is not my main thing, but when I came here I didn't want, it was 16 years, so I didn't want to do it, I wanted something new, and I, as I said, I fell in love with Pakistani culture and music, so I just decided to do that. I met this lovely singer, Kumail Jafri. He's an amazing, amazing singer, and he said, like, I'm looking for a manager. I said, like, okay. Let's give it a try. I don't have an experience, but let's do it. And he's like, yes, you are on board.
Awesome.
And we started working together, and it's been really great so far.
I think you have a very exciting job.
Yes, it is very exciting. I love
it. It's high-powered.
Yes, that's true.
Yes. On that note, we're going to see Poland's high-powered 1,000-year history and a few glimpses of Agata's beautiful country, Poland. So I would like you to see it, and if you wish to travel, you can see what's all there. Let's take a look at it. Agata, do you get emotional when you see highlights like this of your country?
Because I haven't been to Poland for 2 years.
For 2 years?
Because of COVID,
yes,
situation.
So when do you plan to go next?
Well, I was planning during summer, but it didn't work
yes.
out. So maybe in December.
Your family back home?
Yes.
And who all is there?
That's my brother and his family and my parents.
Have they ever visited Pakistan?
No.
And do they plan to?
Well, my brother, he plans it because he's into tourism as well. And,
oh, really?
Yes, and he likes traveling. But my parents, they said it's too hot.
Oh.
they can't do that.
Get them here in the winter time then.
Well, yeah. I was planning, but you know, it's always an issue. No, not many people know that, but it's also an issue to get a visa for foreigners to Pakistan.
Yeah, but now things are easing up.
Yes, Taras.
Relatively,
huh.
So you could probably try for them.
Huh, I can
I'm
try.
I'm sure they'll love it.
Yeah, so, I'm sure they will in winter.
So the Pakistani food palette, I mean, for a European, a Polish person, was it difficult to adjust to it?
Well, I love spicy food.
You do?
Yeah, I do love spicy food. So I love food in general. I'm a foodie. So I really loved it. But it was difficult to adjust because we actually in Poland, we use maybe 2-3 spices maximum.
Yeah, you don't have much spices.
Yes,
at all.
So, yeah. But you know, in general in Europe, our food is not rich.
It's more rich in terms of dairy.
Yes. But I mean, food of Pakistan is like the music of Pakistan and culture, very much.
Which instrument inspires you the most in the Pakistani culture, the music instrument?
I love sitar.
Wow, good choice.
I just love it.
It's very soothing and therapeutic, I feel.
Very much. So that's, I think, my favorite Pakistani instrument.
Right. So the language, I'm sure you've crossed that barrier.
Yes, there was a huge, because Urdu and Punjabi is totally different than Polish and English. You know, back in Poland, I used to learn Hindi for 1 year because there was no Urdu course. It's very similar, but it was basically I learned how to write in
you
Hindi,
do?
Yes, but it's useless here because obviously
wow,
you have
but
totally
that's amazing.
Different.
I mean, to acquire skills, I mean, any language.
Yeah, but you know, it's
speaking
been,
or writing.
Yeah, I would
it's
prefer
phenomenal.
To. I would prefer to learn how to speak than how to write.
But you can speak in Urdu.
Not much. I understand, but I
can't. But you can understand.
If I have to communicate with people that cannot speak English,
well,
I will.
Well, you see, a lot of expats have moved to Pakistan as more and more foreigners that I interview in this program. I have learned that so many foreigners from all over the world, I'm just not referring to Europe here or America.
Yeah.
I'm talking about many other nations. They come to Pakistan, they fall in love with it, they find it exciting, exotic, and very interesting. So I'm sure you have an expat community here too, that you're in touch with.
With some people, not many to be honest, because the ones that are here are usually in Islamabad.
Yes. But Lahore has a handful of people too.
Yes, expats. now they are more coming because of ISEC organization. They are bringing students here and startups for foreigners. So
absolutely.
So there are more, but still there are not many.
But why did you choose Lahore as your destination?
Because my group who came to Poland, they were from Lahore.
Have you been to other cities?
Yes, obviously.
I'd like
I visited
to talk about
all
that.
Over Pakistan.
I'm definitely going to talk about that, and I'd like to include Dr. Ijaz in that discussion as well, because if Agata is missing out on something in beautiful Pakistan, I'm sure we can fill her in about which places to visit next, and I'm sure you're going to learn a lot too. But right after this short break,
we have mountains not as beautiful as in Pakistan, because they
it's
are the,
so
the
nice
most
to
beautiful
say that, but it's a fact.
they are the most beautiful mountains in the world.
It keeps you young when you interact with the youth.
The country is not very big, so it's very easy. In 6 hours, you can go from the sea to the mountains through lakes. So
by walking, I mean?
Nay, by car.
By car, okay.
That's, but still, it's fast.
I was in a shock.
Anyway, by walk, it's not that small.
The tourism must be made part of curriculum.
पोलैंड के बारे में इतने कुछ इंटरेस्टिंग फैक्ट्स हैं जो मैं आपके साथ थोड़े बहुत शेयर करूंगी कि आप जानते हैं कि साल 2008 में जब दुनिया भर की इकोनॉमीज दुनिया भर के ममालिक अफेक्ट हुए रिसेशन से पोलैंड एक वाहिद मुल्क था जो इस रिसेशन से बच निकला बहुत बड़ी बात है और पोलैंड में स्टैंडर्ड ऑफ लिविंग जो है वो काफ़ी बेहतर है और बहुत अच्छा कहा जा सकता है अगर हम बाकी ममालिक से कंपेयर करें एंड ऑल्सो अनएम्प्लॉयमेंट रेट बहुत कम है अगेन एक खुशहाल मीशत की यही निशानी है वेल वी टॉकिंग आई वाज जस्ट लेटिंग आवर ऑडियंस नो अबाउट सम ऑफ द ग्रेट थिंग्स अबाउट पोलैंड हाउ द कंट्री मैनेज्ड टू एस्केप द 2008 रिसेशन द अनएम्प्लॉयमेंट रेट इज़ वेरी लो एंड देन ऑल्सो लेट्स नॉट फॉरगेट इट हैज़ लो प्राइवेट डेट These are great factors.
That's true. We are doing quite well, mashallah.
Yes, and let's not forget, 1,000-year-old history.
yes, that's true.
So, and you know, tourism increased a lot in Poland.
Yes, we have, you know, Poland, we have beautiful lakes, as you saw. We have mountains, not as beautiful as in Pakistan, because
that's
they are
the
most
beautiful.
That's
so nice of you to say that, but it's a fact.
they are the most beautiful mountains in the world. And we have the sea, not also as beautiful, although maybe.
It actually, the sea is quite beautiful.
Yes, let's
accept that.
Yes, so and the country is not very big, so it's very easy. In 6 hours you can go from the sea to the mountains through lakes. So
by walking, I mean?
Nay, by car,
okay.
That's, but still, it's fast.
I was in a shock.
And by walk, it's not that small.
Yes.
Yeah, but still.
But it's gorgeous. If one is planning to visit Europe, Poland should be on your bucket list.
Yes, and it's in. Exactly in the center of Europe, so it's a great
you
point
actually
just
border
to travel.
With Russia, Lithuania,
Russia,
and
yes,
Czech Republic,
Germany,
yes,
and Sweden.
And a lot of
people,
you know, visit Germany, especially from Pakistan. So if they are in Germany, do make sure that you also cross
please,
the border
yes.
and go to Poland.
Yes,
and like Agata is telling us, you can by car, not by walking, in 6 hours get to the mountains. How amazing is that? How convenient is that? Well, Doc Saab, Agata has been here in Pakistan for 4 years. She lives in Lahore. Where all have you been, if you could tell us? In Pakistan.
Well, I've been to many places due to traveling with musicians and bands. But I've been to north, to Hunza. I've been to Gilgit. I've been to Islamabad. Obviously, that's
Karachi,
Multan, Peshawar, and a lot of small places like I don't know if I pronounce it well, Faisalabad. It's very difficult
yes,
to pronounce.
You pronounce it correctly.
So a lot of
well,
small.
Well, you've been to many places, and but most of these places are like relatively larger towns, smaller towns.
Yes.
But Doc Saab, please, if we can tell Agata, and especially if you can let her know about some of our hidden gems that we have in the country.
Pakistan is blessed in a number of such gems. I think that she should also be make a visit to northern areas.
She has been there, we have some very nice palaces in Bahawalpur and all these places.
There are very interesting places even in Balochistan. Yeah, there are certain issues there, but Balochistan is a beautiful terrain.
It's gorgeous.
And you can find very natural beauty over there. Well, their mountains are entirely different from rest of Pakistan. Dry mountains. Yeah, Hina Lake is very beautiful place.
Is there a lake?
Yeah,
Hina
yeah.
Lake? I'm Hina, so it's very close to my name.
Hina Lake.
I got to visit that.
That's a beautiful place. Many other areas of Balochistan are worth seeing, I think. Mm-hmm. If you find an opportunity, you must make a visit to Balochistan. And you will enjoy their terrain. It's a variety of terrain over there. So Quetta is itself, though it is no overpopulated, because Quetta is my birthplace.
You were born in Quetta, Doc Saab?
Yeah. So at that time, Quetta was beautiful valley, enriched with almond trees
and greenery.
But due to certain factor like the Afghan refugees inflow in this region.
So but now things are better, obviously. Things are definitely better.
Things are being improved now.
Yes.
Yeah.
Look at Sawat, how it transformed, and now it's
one
of the major tourist attractions for any tourist who comes in. But Doc Saab, I've heard some beautiful things about Quetta, like, you know, snowfall. You look out of your window, see snow there. You see beautiful trees, like almond trees you mentioned.
Yeah.
So tell us about some more exciting things in Quetta during your childhood.
Yeah, as you said, that what we believe that it was our childhood then, that the snowfall was very, you see that we'd never used to such type of thing like fan, like fridge, because the weather condition was so good, even in June was so good in Quetta, that the winter was intense, minus temperature was over there.
Right, obviously.
And extreme.
But summers were very comfortable.
Summer were very comfortable.
I'm sure you would always look forward to summers there.
Yeah, but no, the situation has entirely been changed there. No, they use air condition, they use other such
appliances.
Because
of climate change?
Yeah, climate change, that is the reason. And also demographic changes.
And they say there's some beautiful plants and trees, very unique ones, exquisite ones in Balochistan, things that you don't see elsewhere in Pakistan.
Yeah, some many exclusive things which are only grown in this terrain. And similarly, certain cultural aspects, which is the Baloch culture. Baloch culture is also very rich. Their dresses, their food is very different.
Well, I think Pakistan, regionally, every region in within Pakistan, every province has its own story.
Exactly.
Its own culture.
Exactly.
There are different ethnicities, there are different cultures, historically speaking. So Balochistan differs completely from Khyber Pakhtunkhwa, Khyber Pakhtunkhwa to Sindh, Sindh to Punjab. Beautiful. The diversity is just amazing.
That's true.
And so many languages spoken.
So many languages. Where we were living in childhood, you see, that was a small locality. In our immediate neighborhood, certain families were Pashtuns.
Yes.
Barawi, Balochi, Hazarajat, Punjabi. So all communities were living in one locality in a very congenial atmosphere to care each others. So
that's the beauty of it.
Yeah, that was.
But Doc Sahib, what brought you to Lahore then?
It was due to the transfer government job of my father. So he was transferred in Punjab. So we decided to settle down in here. So that was my early childhood. 10 years of my life.
Doctor, but a peaceful childhood. Now you interact with 4,000 students every day.
4,000
students. What a contrast.
Yeah. It's college, public sector college, where 4,000 students are enrolled from different levels, from higher secondary.
There must be so much love and hate both at the same time for you.
Yeah.
Some people might love you, some people can hate you. Right? The position you're at.
Yeah. So, I think that it keeps you young when you interact with the youth. You know better that when you interact with the youth, you keep yourself young. So we try to groom them. We try to make them a good human being, good Pakistani. And so we focused on their character building as well. So what I believe that one thing which is lacking, that what I wanted, that there we must have to bring certain changes in our curriculum, that tourism must be made part of curriculum.
So
our students, they should be
but
given.
Do you offer some course related to tourism at the college?
You see that there were certain.
You could do a diploma. You could offer a diploma.
We are not going towards this direction because this is the policy of our department, that we will have to introduce such disciplines, such fields where there are more job opportunities. So tourism is one of them.
Yes, because so with so many hotels opening up, hotel management is an integral part.
Yeah.
And should be an integral part of any curriculum in any college, because if students pick and choose that course, they will in future, or a degree, not just a course, maybe it should be a degree, and there are some schools for it, but it should be available or accessible to many others, let's say in a public sector college. That's going to give students the opportunity to engage and be a part of new professions, new occupations. Because there's an immense opportunity, and I think we need trained people in that.
Exactly. This change is being, they are bringing such changes in the curriculum and such type of.
Doctor, have you made any suggestions?
Yeah, why not? We have made a suggestion that the student must be such new subjects where the job opportunities are more than the traditional.
Because we need to come out of the stereotype, doctor.
Engineer,
and also a business management student.
Yeah.
Right? We need to get out of that, cycle.
Tourism.
I wouldn't say vicious cycle. It's definitely not vicious. Education is very important in any form. But, learning something about the tourism industry is going to open new avenues for students. They could become entrepreneurs as well.
Exactly. You see that this is very important, and we will have to shift our education on this direction, that we will have to bring the students on entrepreneurship, that they should prioritize to work in any government sector department or any private,
which
they should,
is also great. Yeah. Why not? It's respectable, everything. But let's open up new and more exciting courses for students and degrees for students, so they have their minds open up to new occupations.
Exactly.
And because that's actually going to improve the economy. Let's put it that way.
We are living in information technology age. So it offers immense opportunities for the youth. So they should, if they just have to apply their mind and to find out the opportunities for them.
But it's the job of formal institutions to guide their students in that direction.
Exactly.
And music festival, I had this question, I had to come back to you, Gata. Tell me about the music festival in Poland.
Well, so
that you used to manage. And
so our music festival, we started in 2012, and it was basically folk music and dance. So we were inviting every year, we were inviting groups from all over the world, and for around 400 people.
Yeah, people from Asia as well.
From obviously Asia, New Zealand, USA, all countries, all over the world. Each continent had like their place there. Not only Europe, actually we were not that interested in European music, we already knew them.
We wanted with other continents as
well. So we even once had this group from Africa, which were like tribal
amazing music.
They came just covered with leathers of animals, that's all. And they were still tribal musicians, and they were using their music to fight between tribal fights and wars. So this was very organic, and we were organizing this festival for 5 years, then now due to corona.
Well, that gives me an idea. You should actually engage Agata into organizing a music festival at your college. How about your the singers that you manage, they come and perform there?
Well, why not? We have actually
we can only allow Sufi music.
Yeah, why not? Why not?
Sufi music is very popular among the youth, present youth.
Well, Doc Saab, you must talk about it, but we can do that in this break. So it's time for a break, and when we return, we're going to continue our discussion. Let's hope there's a deal here. See you after a short break. Pakistanis are very good drivers.
I know. And very fast as well.
Everywhere in the world. I believe that even in Poland, Pakistani food must have been over there.
Polish people love Pakistani food. They love it. They absolutely love Pakistani food.
Yeah,
because it's excellent. It's one of the best food in the world, after Italian.
That's so nice of you to say that.
Yeah.
That's lovely. Well, I hope this deal has been sealed. I hope so. The deal that I'm referring to is that Agata can manage and organize a Sufi music festival at Doc Saab's college.
Yeah.
Doc Saab, Sufi music you mentioned.
Yes.
Yes, we have faith in you.
All right.
Given you've been managing music festivals, it speaks volumes. Doc Saab, if we were to explain Sufi music in simple terms to Agata, how would it be?
You see that the most distinguished feature of the Sufi music is that it is very close to your spiritual aspect of your life. It gives you a spiritual satisfaction which ones need, like as you need fast music,
it's
classical
food
music
for the soul, basically.
So spiritual means it satisfies your soul. It is very close to your soul. It's wording, Baba Bulle Shah,
you heard of him?
Mia Muhammad Baksh, and similarly many other Sufi saints. So their verses are really that inspire the human beings. And you see that the foreigners more involve themselves in Sufi music than sometimes over the local people. So when our singers perform outside the countries, Sufi performers, so they are rapt attention. They listen the rapt attention, and they enjoyed it.
Yes, I know. I'm like my musician. The musicians that I work with are mostly from musician culture, traditional families, so-called daris. So they are classically trained musicians. So they perform Sufi music, they know kavalis, they know rags and everything. They play traditional instrument, bajas and tabla. So I'm like also very close to Sufi music. I love Sufi music, and I do understand that this is something totally different that we love in Europe, we love in America, and exactly what you said, that this is something that speaks to your soul.
You see that in all the four provinces, as I said, that there are different ethnic groups speaking different languages. So all the provinces of Pakistan have their Sufi, peculiar Sufi music and Sufi poets. So either in, you see in Pashto language, you see Rahman Baba and many others in Sindh, Shah Abdul Latif Bitai. In Balochistan, you see Mir Chakar Rind and many other. So in Punjab, a number of Sufi saints. Punjab is very rich. Punjabi language is very rich language. As far as the Sufi language is
concerned.
A number of Sufi poets, number of, as I said, Baba Bulle Shah, Shah Farid, Khwaja Ghulam Farid, and Waris Shah, Mia Muhammad Baksh. So these are Sufi saints in Punjabi language, and their verses, when one sing, so you just feel that you are, you know.
Doctor, but I would like to know something in continuation to Dr. Saab's very nicely explained concept of Sufism and the human connection to Sufi music. How did it start and why did it start? But why and how did you develop interest in cultural music? Because you see, you're from the new generation.
No.
So it's rare that you find that connection. How did your connection with cultural music begin?
So this is what I was, this is like music is international language, right? When Pakistani group came to Poland, they were playing traditional music and Sufi music as well. It was not something like pop or dance, right? So obviously we didn't understand any, even one word in Urdu or Punjabi, because it's totally different language. Yes, but you know, you listen to it and you feel the vibe, you feel this music in you.
I get it.
So you don't even have to understand. And our festival was like that. No one understood any of the languages. No one sang
music
in English.
But music has no languages.
Yes, that's why,
it may
you know,
be cliched easy. When I say that, but it's
but
a fact.
But it's true.
Right, so Agata, I want you to share a fun fact with the viewers here, because enough of a serious discussion. A fun fact that you shared with me right before we started, right before I started interviewing you, I asked you, how do I pronounce your name? And you gave me a Punjabi version of that.
Yes. that was because my surname is Dudkevich. I was told it means in the milk. Dud, I knew that Dud is milk. And also my name Agata, very often I say Parata. Agata Parata.
Parata Dudkevich.
Yes, Parata Dudkevich. Parata in the milk.
Talks are finds it very amusing.
It's quite interesting. Yeah. Dudkevich.
Yeah, but thanks to that, actually it's very difficult to pronounce, but once you know.
It's very easy now.
That's perfect.
I'm never forgetting your name.
I'm so glad.
Well, so if you ever see Parata
Dudkevich. Yeah, that's interesting.
Well, that's a very smart way to make people, remember your name in a new country. So I'm going to show you some images now, our regular feature of this show, where there'll be an image from Pakistan, there'll be an image from Poland, and we'll see the similarities between the two. Doc Saab can comment on the Pakistani side and Agata Parata on the Polish side.
Yes, I will try my best.
Right, so let's take a look at it. So, Doc Saab, do you recognize this terrain?
Yeah, look at there. That is most probably our northern areas.
Of course.
Yeah, because rich greenery is over there. The mountains are
but
very green.
But look at the similarities, huh?
Yeah.
Agata?
Right, yes. Yes, this is Pięć Stawów, our lake in Polish mountains near Zakopane.
It's very beautiful again. And look at the clear water.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Gorgeous.
Oh,
same.
Gorgeous.
Wow, dense gorgeous. Forest.
The same.
Same, yeah, yes.
But how lovely, how refreshing.
Yeah, it is.
So full of oxygen.
So oxygen.
Absolutely. Which is very rare now in COVID
oh,
period.
Yes.
Yeah,
oh,
you
yes,
have
doctor.
Immense oxygen over there.
Yes.
So look at there.
It's yeah. green, it's gorgeous.
Actually, it's very close. I recognize this place. It's very close, around 20 kilometers from my city, my town.
So your hometown is?
My town is near Krakow, Myślenice.
Right.
Another difficult name. And
I'm sure you'll come up with a shortcut for that. Well, in Pakistani.
Not yet. But it means like I think nice.
Right. So you live in a mountainous, surrounded
yes,
by a mountainous
yes,
area?
It's very similar to Natyagali.
Oh,
yeah,
beautiful.
Yeah. How not very, not like really like Hunza, so it's more like Natyagali.
Generally, one asks the distance of your place from your capital, how long it's away from Warsaw?
From Warsaw to the mountains, it's 5 hours.
Not
drive.
Bad.
5 hours.
She mentioned earlier, like 6 hours, 5 hours. Yeah. Yeah.
And then 2 hours more and we have the Baltic Sea.
How
so,
nice.
Yeah. And on the way
so
you have lakes.
So you're saying 9 hours in total to Baltic?
Huh. Depends how fast you can drive.
Yeah, we're good at it. Pakistanis are very good drivers.
Oh, I know. And very fast as well.
Yes. So, well, if one is to visit Poland, what places would you recommend?
Well, I would recommend, first of all, to come to Krakow. Warsaw is the capital city, but Krakow is the first capital city of Poland. I mean, actually second, but the most important, I live very close. That's why I'm saying I love this place. It's beautiful, really rich in culture, very old. We can see the castle of our kings still remain because during the war it was not, thank God, demolished by Germans. So Krakow, for sure, Warsaw also, Wrocław, Gdańsk and Gdynia by the sea, that we also saw the images, beautiful beaches there,
actually
mountains, Zakopane, yes. So there are a lot of places, but and since it's very small country, you can visit them all.
What about food? What special food
yeah,
over
I was
there?
Just gonna come to that.
All right, so I would recommend you to try pierogi. Pierogi is our Polish food, which is like dumplings. They are like samosas, but not fried, boiled.
I think Pakistani, with the Pakistani palate, it's very similar to that.
No, actually, Pakistanis, they couldn't even eat it because they said it's tasteless.
Yeah. Oh.
You know, because it's like...
So there comes in Tabasco.
Don't know, we don't use Tabasco.
We would if we find it bland.
Yeah, but it's we have Polish traditional soup, chicken soup, which very much tastes like yachni.
Okay.
Yachni, yeah.
Yachni. It's almost the same.
I think every country, the food of that country is driven by its climate and weather.
Yeah.
So
exactly.
It's the need there.
But one thing is very important that in everywhere in the world, I believe that in even Poland, Pakistani food must have been over there. There must be Pakistani restaurants over
now,
there.
You travel all
and
the way to Poland and why
and
would
you local
go to a
people
restaurant
also
there?
No, people of Poland, they love Pakistani food and there are not many Pakistani restaurants, more Indian I must say.
Yeah.
But
yeah.
Still, there are some Pakistani restaurants probably in Krakow. There are like two of them. I love them. One is called Zaika, which is, means a taste, right?
Yes,
and whenever I was there, I was going there. I love, Polish people love Pakistani food. They love it. They absolutely love Pakistani food because it's excellent. It's one of the best food in the world after Italian.
That's so nice of you to say that.
Yeah.
That's lovely. So which is your favorite Pakistani dish?
Oof, I love dal chawal. Dal chawal.
Oh my God, I already feel hungry now.
Yes,
oh
I love dal chawal.
You do?
Yes.
So now, Agata, what's your plan like? In terms of living in Pakistan, 4 years already in Pakistan, do you plan to continue your journey here?
Yes, I do plan to continue my journey here in music industry as well, but I started working as well at school recently, like 6 months ago. So I'm somehow back to my roots, which is teaching. So this is kind of
You're
mission.
Teaching the English language here?
Well, I'm an administrator. So I prepare syllabus. We are changing it more into modern ones. And also I work with Umer Hussain, who is working for tourism in Pakistan. And he's now opening a new project, Orange Loft, all over the Pakistan. And he's changing the, he's working for the beautification of Pakistan. I already work with him with many projects. And now we are having a lot of actions to make Pakistan a more beautiful place. This Sunday, I invite everyone to come to Andhroon, Hiramandi, to clean. We are going to collect trash.
What a good movement. What a good movement. Yeah. So you've obviously seen the food street.
Obviously.
And you love it, right?
Oh, I love it. I love it.
And I tell you, good weather's on its way. So we all are going to flock towards the food street.
Yes, yes.
Let's hope COVID is down.
Inshallah.
Well, Dr. Saab, thank you so much. We loved hearing about your childhood especially, which came as a breath of fresh air. And we hope that we all get to visit those places as well. Agata, yes. That should be...
I would love
to
go.
That should be on your list.
Yes, it is, but... Yes, I want to go.
It is really a very pleasant experience to interact with Agata. It's
very absolutely.
And we learn a lot.
She's a positive person.
We learn a lot about Poland.
Yes.
And the Poland's culture.
Well, let the flights open up. We're going there.
Please, let's go together. I want to go.
Yeah, that makes sense. Yeah. Well, thank you so much, Agata.
Thank you so much.
And so nice talking to you in terms of... I learned so much about your country today. I learned about the fact that, you know, never say no. You come to a new place, you settle down there, you explore new things, and I love the positive energy that you brought here.
Thank you so much.
I'll be seeing you again with new guests from another exciting country. Tab tak ke liye khuda hafiz, aur aap dekhte rahiyega Discover Pakistan.